네, 오늘은 미래에셋증권과 글로벌X의 콜라보레이션 시리즈로 파괴적 혁신에 대해서 조금 더 세밀하게 들여다보는 시간 갖도록 하겠습니다. 가장 인기 있는 테마 중에 하나가 바로 전기차 아니겠습니까? 그래서 전기차에 관해서 글로벌X의 페드로 팔란주라니 디렉터 분과 얘기 한번 나눠보도록 하겠습니다.
How are you?
Good, thanks for having me.
Let's start by discussing the current trends in EV market. In your opinion, what are the most promising developments in this sector?
Absolutely. I think more importantly, electric vehicles continue to become cheaper, right? More accessible to consumers. We're also seeing pretty much every single car company around the world bringing an electric vehicle model to market. So that's definitely opening up the opportunity for consumers to actually try different brands, different type of cars. But at the same time, if we look more narrow to electric vehicles, battery technology is where we see a lot of the technological improvements. They're getting better, they're getting cheaper. So that's definitely where we see a lot of technological innovation today.
Do you ride an EV?
I don't, unfortunately. I live in New York, so in New York, you don't really need a car. You don't really need a car. The subway gets you everywhere.
How about the charging environments in New York?
In New York specifically, perhaps it's not very well developed, but New York has very high density of population and in a very small territory. However, in the United States as a whole, we continue to see the rollout of charging infrastructure. Just a few months ago, the number of charging stations in the United States was slightly lower than 100,000. But in the next few years, we're likely going to get to 500,000 stations in the United States, definitely making electric vehicles better just because you're going to have more ways to charge your car.
But there is a scarcity of raw material to be made for the battery. It's getting harder for EV makers. And of course, in my opinion, it seems that there is some pressure to keep the battery prices from falling any further. So what do you think?
Yeah, in 2022, it was the first time after 10 years of battery price declines where we actually saw battery prices going up, unfortunately. To your point, key raw materials are definitely one of those key factors that made the battery prices go up. And as investors, I think that actually represents an opportunity because investing in the companies that are getting those raw materials are perhaps one of the best ways to invest in the electric vehicle supply chain. In our view, lithium, which is the key common denominator across battery technology, perhaps offer the best investment opportunity. You can change your nickel, you can change your manganese, your cobalt, you can change pretty much your chemistry structure, but you cannot change lithium. Lithium is that key material that is so important in battery technology.
That is now good timing to invest in Albemarle or something?
Albemarle, the largest lithium miner in the world. I would say the universe of lithium miners is a very concentrated industry. If you look at the top five lithium miners, Albemarle, SQM, Ganfeng Lithium in China, Alchem in Livent, now merging actually. So you have a very small number of companies that contribute to more than 50% of the global lithium supply. And so I think that those are companies that are very well positioned. They're benefiting from higher lithium prices. They're also increasing their capacity. So I think that's very powerful and it's helping these companies.
Okay. There is some possibility and anxiety about economic recession. It's like a macro question. Economic recession in the near future, that could make a kind of situation that the EV demands lack. So what do you think about it?
It could be the case, right? And clearly, within a recession, this discretionary spending tends to get hurt. However, I think on a relative basis to internal combustion engine cars, electric vehicles are definitely a choice of option for consumers. Just because, one, EV prices are actually coming down and we're seeing companies like Tesla actually lowering the price very aggressively. Two, again, you have more options, as I mentioned before. And at the same time, these are environmental friendly options, right? Mm-hmm. So I think consumers are actually favoring electric vehicles over internal combustion engine mm-hmm. cars. And I also think that in 2022, EV sales were about 10 million units. I think this year we're comfortably going to exceed that number. And it's likely that EVs will continue to grow anywhere between 30 to 40%.
Mm. And last question, and what do you have thoughts on autonomous driving? As generative AI getting popular, people's interest and hypes on it are faded. So makes sense.
Yeah, it makes sense. AI is now a main topic of discussion, of course, and AI is so important for autonomous vehicles. Mm. I think autonomous vehicles is still the very early days. However, we continue to see a lot of development from Tesla's full self-driving technology, which is just getting better and better upgrades. Google also with Waymo, GM Cruise. You're seeing a lot of companies actually doing a lot of improvements on the autonomous vehicle front. However, it's early days. We need to understand that it's likely that autonomous vehicles will start gaining adoption perhaps within the next 5 to 7 years. Mm-hmm. By 2030 at Global X, we're expecting that 10% of the new car sales are actually going to be fully autonomous. So we still have few years away until we start seeing autonomous vehicles starting to pick up.
Okay. What should investors look out for in these sectors?
I think the shift towards electric vehicles is unstoppable, right? Mm. We expect by 2030 that about 35 to 40% of total car sales are going to be electric. And that's a conservative estimate. But even with that number, there are definitely a lot of opportunities within the supply chain of electric vehicles, from upstream lithium miners to midstream battery technology companies. And even downstream, you're going to see a lot of electric vehicle companies also benefiting. But again, I think as investors, as we try to understand opportunities within the transportation industry, electric vehicles are definitely very well positioned.
What is your favorite EV makers?
There are many. I cannot say one, but clearly Tesla, Ford is definitely bringing very attractive EV models to market, GM as well, and even the European ones, BMW, Daimler. There are so many attractive car makers today.
Very safe.
Yeah.
Very safe answer.
Yeah.
Pandron, is there something you want to add for lastly?
No, thank you so much for having me. It was fun.
Mr. Pandrani, thank you for sharing your valuable insights with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.